we already learned that if we have two objects whose mass is mass A and mass B connected by means of a string and passes that over a frictionless pulley, ignoring the friction on the string and the pulley itself, and ignore also the air resistance that might affect the motion of the system, and consider only the effect of gravity, we call that as the Atwood machine. Now, remember that the Atwood machine is a good demonstration material for studying a uniformly accelerated body, because in the Atwood machine, we can provide a constant acceleration. Now, take note that in our previous video, we derived the acceleration of the Atwood machine as the product of the Earth's gravitational acceleration multiplied by the difference between the two masses, and we use mass B minus mass A because we assume that B will move downward, and divide it by mass A plus mass B. That will be the theoretical acceleration, magnitude of acceleration of the system of the Atwood machine. Meaning, without the system, without the materials, or without the device, we can always provide the acceleration of the system by simply substituting the values, the masses, to that formula. Now, if the result of the acceleration after substituting the values of mass A and mass B to that formula, if the result is positive, it means to say that the object B will move downward. Hence, A will move upward because they are connected by means of that cord or string. Now, if the result is negative, then it means to say that B will move upward. Hence, A will move downward. Okay, so it depends upon the masses. The heavier the object will dominate the motion downward. And that is based on that formula. And remember that the acceleration of a device is directly proportional to the difference between the two masses, which means that if you have a greater difference between the two, it provides a greater acceleration. Hence, it will the velocity will keep on increasing with greater magnitude. Remember that the acceleration is actually signifies change of velocity. Okay, now if the result of the acceleration after calculating is zero, then the system is at rest, and it happens only if the two masses have the same value. Okay, so all of this is purely a theoretical idea, meaning by the use of our mathematical ability, we can provide the acceleration of the system, the constant acceleration. And we can also provide the theoretical calculation of the tension in the cord. Okay, so let us verify this theory by performing an experiment of the Atwood machine. And we will be using sensor to do the activity. This will be our setup to obtain the experimental acceleration. Now remember that we can always provide the acceleration of the system using the theory, using the formula of the acceleration multiplied by the change in, or the difference between masses divided by the sum of the two masses. Now, this setup will provide an experimental acceleration and compare it to the theory so that we can provide the percent error of the experiment. Okay, we are using the for the pulley, we use the rotary motion sensor. So this will detect the angle, no? The angle of the wheel while moving, or wheel rotate, as rotating, no? So using that sensor, that the data will be transmitted to the computer. Okay, so we will use the masses, no, for the loads A and B using the hanger. The hanger was connected to the string, and we have the slots for the loads. We will increase or decrease the amount of load. Okay, we will vary the load, the difference between the two, and for every loads, we will obtain the acceleration of the system. Now this hanger is a 5 grams, so meaning we will add that to the load, because remember that mass is should be the total mass of the motion. Then we have the interface, no? So these are the materials that we need to use: the sensor, the load, and the interface. The interface will receive the signal from the sensor and transmit that to the system or the PC computer. Okay, so we have the PC, and the PC, we have also the application of the PC that is compatible to the interface. So they will communicate each other. Now in the apps, we can provide a tabular form, and we can also provide the graphical presentation of that data. So all the data coming from the sensor will be received to the interface, then send it to the computer. We have the set of masses, the weights. We have different masses. So we have the 4 hangers, and the loads will we have the 100 grams, we have the 50, we have the 20, 10, up to 0.5 grams. So it varies with the masses. So we can have it any load that we want to. Okay, so take note that we will be using this one to compute or to obtain the theoretical or the experimental acceleration. So the sensor will send data to the interface. Right? So we have the red color, meaning the sensor is connected to interface. Then from the interface, it will be connected towards the PC. So this will be the setup. Every time we change the masses A and B, it has a corresponding acceleration delivered to the PC, and we will obtain that value and compare it with the theoretical idea. So this is our actual setup. This is the rotary motion sensor. This is the frictionless, no? This is designed as almost perfectly a frictionless pulley. And we have these masses. The string was connected to the hanger. Remember, the hanger is 5 grams, and we have this load, no? And for now, we have this 500 grams, both sides, they have the same mass. So you can notice that there's no motion of this particle. This motion sensor was connected to the interface. Okay, and the interface was connected to the computer. And now, the interface and the computer application are communicating to each other. Anytime, if we have these changes of this rotation of the rotary motion sensor, will be detected to the app. Now for now, from the app, look at the app. We have in my left side, I think that's left side, is the So the capstone up from the Pasko. Then our interface is 850 universal interface from Pasko again, and also with this sensor. In the upper is our spreadsheet. The spreadsheet is ready to calculate. All we need to do is to feed in. No? Take note that we have the trials, no? First column, and we have the mass A, we have mass B, and we have the two accelerations, the theoretical and experimental. In the last column, we have the percent error. So remember, if the percent error is less than 10, it means to say that we will consider the result, meaning there's no significantly difference in our assumption. Okay, then the theoretical, remember, is computed by multiplying the Earth's gravitational acceleration using this formula, no? Just into that spreadsheet. The acceleration of gravity multiplied by mass B minus mass A divided by the sum of A and B, then the result will be automatically fed into the spreadsheet. Okay, and the percent difference, percent error, was computed by subtracting the theoretical minus the experimental. So meaning we have the difference and divide it by the theoretical, which we considered as the accepted value. So we use the theoretical as the basis because we are measuring how far is the theory or the experimental away from the theory. So the result is the percent difference. Okay, so look at the system. Remember that they have the same masses. So when I pull must be upward, then release, surely it won't move. Why? Because they have the same masses. The acceleration is zero. Now anytime we add a load, no, even if a very very small load, then this will rotate. So if I reverse it, still this is at rest. So meaning there's, remember, in first load, because there's no net external force on this, so the body will move at rest. Okay, so let's try the sensor. Oh, take note in our app, we have the time and we measure the time and we measure the acceleration. This is linear acceleration. Okay, now we have also the graph, no? And the graph is the time versus the acceleration. So from that table, automatically the graph will appear on the in the graph itself. Time and acceleration. Okay, so let's try. So to do it is we need to do is to push the record, no? You just click the record, and after that it will start calculating. So in that case, so since there's no difference, and when I click this one, so expect that there's no acceleration. Look at the result, no? Point something, 0.00. So meaning there's no acceleration because there's no difference. Now so to stop this one, to click again the stop, then you notice that our app collects data, the time and its acceleration. We can add column, we can add distance, no, the displacement, and we can add also column for velocity. So for now we are interested for the time and acceleration, and we can also provide three or more graph on this app: the velocity, acceleration, velocity, time, and time and acceleration, time and velocity, and time and position. So we can provide the ST, VT, and ET graph. For now we are focus on the acceleration time graph. Okay, so let us click the delete last run, so to clear up the table and graph, then just click it. Okay, now let's try to add a load. Now let us say I will add 10 grams. This is 10 grams and this is 50 50. So if I add this to mass B, so take note that this mass B is now heavier compared to mass A. So the moment you release it, the moment you release this one, then the tendency is to have the acceleration. Okay, so let's have the recording process. So all you need to know is to hold the mass B, then we simultaneously we will click the button record. So click the button, then start simultaneous release, no, freely. So then observe the data collections and also the graph. Okay, ready, set, go. So I stop right away because there's a sudden change of the motion. So we have this one. Look at the result. When you look at the result, this is okay in the graph. This first few seconds, this one is actually the ideal one. No, meaning when you look at the result, 1.7 at trial one, we have 0.74, 0.73, 0.72. So this is, then after that we have the 0.69, then 0.7, then suddenly this is the time that they will it strikes, no, the 4.494 is the time that it reaches the ground. So meaning on this we have this result, no, ideal result. Now the hint is find the largest acceleration nga na measure niya. So in this case we have 0.74. So the acceleration system, when you release this one, the acceleration using the sensor, we have this as 0.74. okay, so let's try again, second trial, same load. So just delete this one, then okay, just hold it freely, then after that click the record, then release freely the must be the heavier, the 70. This is 70 grams versus 50, but take note the hanger is 5, so must A is 55 while must B is 75. Okay, so let's do it again. Remember 0.74 is our answer previously. So click, then release. Okay, so again look at the result. We have this first 1, 2, 3 up to 5, we have 0.75, 5, we have 74, 6, 73, 4, 73, 720, 69. So this is the ideal result. So choose the higher value, no, because usually the higher is the, it is where the acceleration is constant and at that level, or you can find the average of the result. You can still do it, but for me I rather choose the heavier or the greater value. In this case we have 0.75 meter per second squared. Okay, so that's it. If we change, so remember this is the acceleration for the 55 versus 75. So if we add again, or if we reduce this one, instead of, oh no, this is 10, so meaning this is 65 versus 55. Okay, we will change, we'll remove the 10 grams, replace it with 5 grams. This is 5 grams, I think. Oh no, this is 2 grams, sorry. This is 2 grams. We will change, we will replace that with 5 grams. So this is 5 grams. So 55 plus 5, this is 60. Okay, so 60 versus 55, a difference of 5 grams. So let's us see the result. So delete the last run, then hold the heavier one, then push the record button simultaneously, then release. Okay, so look at the result. The first, no, second, third, fourth, up to what, up to 11, no, the 0.69 seconds nga time, the time, these are only almost the same, no. Okay, so if I were to choose this one, I rather choose the 0.63 or 36.6, or you can use the 0.355. now usually the first acceleration, you applied a force on that. So after that, it's freely move. Then for me, the acceleration of the system for 55 grams versus 60, the acceleration is 0.354. So this is based on the result of this experiment. Okay, so let's erase again. Then okay, so let us start our proper experiment. Now we will be using the 100 load, 100 grams plus the hanger. So for now, this one is, remember, this is 100 grams and the hanger is 55. So mass A should have, remember that we will be using SI, so convert the grams, the 105 into a kilogram by dividing 1000. So this will be 0.105. so this will be our mass A. This is the mass A, while this one, the other side, is mass B. So for now, we will add, no, by the way, we will fix mass A. This is always 105 grams or 0.105. sorry, this will be 105. So we will copy this throughout the trials, so we will have only 8 trials, meaning 8 varying masses, mass difference. So for mass B, we will have a difference, an increment of 5. So therefore, in mass B, since I added 5 grams, this will be what? This will be 0.110 or 110. Okay, so our mass A is 0.105 or 105 grams, while mass B is 0.110 or 110 grams. So this was has a unit, is a unit of kilograms. Now notice that in the acceleration, the theory is automatically calculated because I had built in the formula. Remember the formula in our theoretical, the A is equal to Z multiplied by MB minus MA divided by MA plus MB or MB plus MA. Okay, and the result is 0.228. Okay, so we will have this column for the experimental, then after that it will automatically calculate the error. Remember the error is percent error, and we use the theory as our reference or the accepted, and our experimental will be the observed value. So theory minus experimental divided by theory, then multiply it 100%, then it should be a percent error or percent difference. Okay, all we need to do is to compare the experimental versus the theory. So the tolerance is 10% below. So if the percent error is less than 10%, then we can say that the experimental result is, the difference between the theory and experimental are not significant. Okay, so again, the mass is 105, mass A, while the mass B is 110. Let's perform the experiment. Okay, so on our app, no, take note, we have the time, acceleration table, and we have the acceleration versus time. So let's hold the mass, the heavier is B, so hold it, then click the record, then release. Okay, that's it. So look at the result. So the result is so we'll start at 1. Okay, so we have 0.1, so trial 1, time 0.1, 0.165, 0.164, 0.163, 0.164, 0.166, 7, 0.169, 0.173, 0.181, 0.19, 195, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198, 198. Okay, so choose the largest value. No, you can choose the, or you can use the average. But for me, I will be using the large value because it is weird that the system now is in constant acceleration. But again, you can use the average. But the average will be taken only, I think this is from 1 to 14. No? Or the at the time at 0.75 seconds. Take the average on that. But for me, I will be using 0.198 for our experimental acceleration. So proceed to our spreadsheet. So our spreadsheet, and we will record this result. This is point, what is it again? 0.198. So this is 0.198 as the experimental result. Okay, so the result is 13. So it is not tolerable because the percent is greater than 10. So let's do it again. Let's try. Do it another trial. Erase this data. Then again. Okay. So then press the record. Then release. Okay. So sorry. Stop. So we will release it freely. Okay. Click record button, then release. Okay, that's it. So this is again point, the highest is 0.195. So therefore this is the result. So we take this as our record. This is our result. So 0.198 is the result of the acceleration. For remember, this is the difference of 5 grams. So let us increase by 5 again. So this will become what? On our must be added by 5 grams. So this will be 0.115. Okay, so difference of 10. So again, this is 55, 105. Okay, so this is now 115 difference. Okay, let's proceed to the app. So erase the record, then hold the here, the must be, then click the record button, then release must be simultaneously. Ready, set, go. Okay. So the data says, or the result says, that the acceleration, the largest acceleration recorded is 0.39, 0.4, 0.405, 0.403. So 0.405 is the largest acceleration. This is where that obtained the constant acceleration. Okay, so 0.405, and the result is 9.17%. So the percent error is now decreasing. Then must be added by 5 grams, this will becomes 0.12 or 120. Okay, 120. So added by 5, so I will change this, remove the 5, then add by 10. This is already 120. Okay, take note that the acceleration theoretical is 0.654, and the mass is 0.12 or 120 grams, a difference of what? A difference of 15. a difference of 15 grams. So 15, 15. So let's have the app perform the experiment. Delete the last recorded run. Push the record button. Then simultaneously release the heavier object. Then observe the data. Ready, set, go. Okay. So the highest recorded acceleration is 0.614. By the way, I ignore the first line because first time usually we have already applied a force on that. So let's adapt the next, and this is 0.61. I think that's the one. Okay, 0.61 meter per second squared. We will be using that one. So therefore, on our spreadsheet again, 0.610. That's it. So the error is 6.73. So our theory is 0.654 and our experimental is 0.610, and the error is, percent error is 6.73. It is now in reducing percentage of error. So let's add another 5. So this will become 0.125 or 125 grams for mass A. Mass B, while mass A is constant of 105 grams. Okay, so the theoretical acceleration is 0.853. So then proceed to the up again. Let's erase the last run recorded, then click the record button, simultaneously release the support on mass B, ready, set, go. Okay, that's it. So again, look at the graph. This is the ideal result, no? So it's from trial 1, 2, 3, up to I think this is only up to 12. So choose the largest value or take the average, you can do it. For me, I'll rather choose the largest value. 0.79 is the largest recorded. 0.79. So this is 0.79, and the error is 7.39. So add again 5. So this will become 0.13. Okay, and the acceleration now is 1.03. That's theoretical acceleration. Okay, push it to the up, delete the last recorded run, then push the record button, then simultaneous release, ready, set, go. Okay, that's it. So we have now the highest recorded except the first attempt. So we have here 0.955. okay, I think that's it. 0.955, or you can use 0.65. 0.965. So 0.955 experimental, and we have 8.49. By the way, you can have several trials for every difference, no? For me, we will be, because I am satisfied with that percent error, no? You can reconduct again for each trial. So then let's proceed. So for the next, we have 0.135 or 135 grams, and our theory says acceleration is 1.226. proceed to the app, clear the data, then click record, then simultaneous release, ready, set, go. Okay. And according to the result, we have 0.975 or 0.960. So do it again. 0.9960. Okay, let's do it again. Alright, very far result. Let's do it again. Now remember that as the difference increases, the velocity is keep on changing. So sometimes we cannot control the one. So be careful on the experiment. Release, post the record button, then release, release it. Go. Okay. And the result again is 0.981, 0.981 as the result. So 0.981. Let's do it again. Ano? Okay. So again, this is, let's count again. 10, 60, 70, sorry, 120, this is 100, 110, 15, 20, 25, oi, what's this, let's review the load. This is 50, 110, this is 15, 20, 25, no, this is 25, 110. 10, 20, 25. Ah, okay. We have the error on the experiment. We use the wrong load. So let's do it again. So let's review the data. This is 110, 15. I think okay, 15. Sige. 115. So 120. Then 125. 130. Okay. So 130. So we will add another one. So we will should be 135. Okay. 10, 20, 30. This is now 135. Okay. So 135 versus 105. Let's erase this one. This is not the experimental. We commit error on the load. So let's do it again. Record, post the record and release, release it, go. Okay, that's 1.12 or 1.102. 1.102, this is 1.102, and the error is 10. Let's do it again to reduce the error. Okay, so ready, set, go. 1.15. Okay, this is the 1.15. The error is 6%. Okay, so add another, and this is 140. 0.14. So do it again. Delete the last run, click the record and release. 1, 2, ready, go. And record says 1.312. So 1.312. That's it, huh? Okay, so it's already greater difference, so we cannot So I think this is only for this up to 7 trial only. So you notice that the result is less than 10% except the 1. No, meaning, what's the meaning of this? The difference of 1 grams or 5 grams, the sensor is provides the greater 10%, but when you increase the load, no, increase the load, it reduces its percent error, no, so except the trial 5, but still this is less than 10, which means that the experimental value, the difference between the experimental and the theoretical are not significant. Okay, so these are the results. So thank you for listening, and see you in the next video.